Hi there, welcome to today's video. Just back from an awesome sunset bike ride. Just a quick half hour, and seeing that I live up on a hill, a half hour bike ride entails 25 minutes uphill and 5 minutes barrel back downhill. So, and the hill that I'm on extends for about 30 miles, so I'm not going to be running out of a hill anytime soon. So I can just pop out onto the hill, barrel up for whatever my designated period of time is, turn around, get back down, and still get down, back down before it's dark. Quick question, athlete question here. I've got Sarah. Sarah's asking me a question, ultramarathon, regarding ultramarathons, and wants to know, what does my week look like running up to an ultra as far as running and nutrition is concerned?
CoachEdu.net.
Well, Sarah, first and foremost, the week running up to an ultra, invariably, especially if it's a organized event, pinning numbers and all such like, if it's an organized event, in all likelihood, your ultra involves some sort of travel getting from where you are now out to where the race venue is. So that factors into your week as well. But in my week running up to an ultra, I taper my run volume right back down. I do not increase my nutrition. I do not try and stuff as many carbs, as much extra food into my body during that last week as what I possibly can. Because what I've done is, by reducing my training volume right down in that final week, but maintaining the same nutrition level as I have in the weeks before, that means that without eating more, I'm able to top up my liver, blood, and muscle glycogen levels right up to their top levels, so that my tanks are full up, tanked up, ready to go on race day. So as far as my week running up to an ultra is concerned, and for me personally, ultras for me are solo, unsupported runs up in the mountain rather than pinning my pinning a race number onto a vest. But that's just my personal preferences. Your personal preferences may be completely different there, Sarah. But as far as the week running up to an ultra is concerned, bring training volumes, training intensities right down low, but maintain the same nutrition level as what I was doing before the event. That's my what I do personally. If you've got something different out there that you do in the week running up to an ultra, post those suggestions for Sarah down in the comment section below this video. Also, don't forget, share this out amongst all your running friends. Thumbs up if you like the content, thumbs down if not. And also, last but by no means least, don't forget to click that big red subscribe button that you see below the video as well. That way you stay subscribed to my channel for all the new content that comes out on a day-to-day, week-to-week basis. Stay carved up for the win out there. I'll see you next time.